We must protect and build on the gains of the last 15 years and march ahead. Because at stake is not just the future of Afghanistan that has been invested in a vision of development, democracy and pluralism, but the peace and stability of this entire region and beyond. Let us also reflect with urgency on what more must be done and what we must avoid in Afghanistan so that its citizens can self-sustain peace and economic growth. The answers are all there. The question is of resolve and action, and of putting Afghanistan and its people first. For this first, an Afghan-led, Afghan-owned, and Afghan-controlled process is a key. It is the only guarantor of durability of solutions. Second, we must demonstrate strong collective will to defeat terror networks that cause bloodshed and spread fear. Terrorism externally induced instability poses the gravest threat to Afghanistan's peace, stability and prosperity. And the growing arc of terrorist violence endangers our entire region. As such, support for voices for peace in Afghanistan alone is not enough. It must be backed by resolute action, not just against forces of terrorism, but also against those who support, shelter, train and finance them. Silence and inaction against terrorism in Afghanistan and our region will only embolden terrorists and their masters. The third, our bilateral and regional commitments on material assistance for Afghanistan's development and humanitarian needs must continue and increase. Our cooperative endeavors in Afghanistan should contribute to its infrastructure and institutional capacity and self-propelling engines of growth. Fourth, we should all work to build stronger positive connectivity between Afghanistan and other countries of the region. Afghanistan should be at the center of our connectivity network, not peripheral up to that. On our part, we see Afghanistan as the hub for strengthening links of connectivity between South Asia and Central Asia.